गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. सो इन कंटिन्यूएशन टू प्रीवियस वीडियो वी आर हियर अगेन स्टार्टिंग विद द चैप्टर 15 बायोडाइवर्सिटी एंड कंजर्वेशन. सो इन दिस पैराग्राफ जस्ट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ बायोडाइवर्सिटी इज गिवन दैट अवर अर्थ प्लैनेट अर्थ इज रिच इन बायोडाइवर्सिटी एंड वी ह्यूमन बीइंग्स आर शेयरिंग our planet with large number of living organism. Here they have given some of the examples that on our earth there are approximately 20,000 species of ants, 3 lakhs species of beetles, 28,000 species of fishes, 20,000 species of orchids. So the ecologist, evolutionary biologist, and they are actually thinking of what is the significance of so many species. So many other questions are also there which arise by observing as many number of species, that did such great diversity exist throughout the earth history? क्या ये सब अर्थ की हिस्ट्री में शुरू से जो आज स्पीशीज हैं वो बिल्कुल शुरू से they were there from the beginning of the earth or not? How did this diversification come about? That means these many number of species, how did they form? And diversity, why is this diversity important to the biosphere? As many number of species are required, are they important to the biosphere? Or what is their function? Or how are they beneficial for the human beings? So these are the various questions which we are to answer about. Now we are here coming the term biodiversity. So in our biosphere there is an immense diversity or heterogeneity exists not only at the species level but at all levels of biological organization. Biological organization we have already seen in the previous chapter that levels of organization start from the macromolecule up to the biosphere, or you can say the till the biomes and biosphere. I can repeat it: macromolecular, cellular level, tissue level, organ system level, individual, and then the species level, then the population level, then ecosystem, biotic community level, ecosystem level, biome and biosphere. So they are saying that rich biosphere has immense diversity at each level of organization. So biodiversity, this term was popularized by a sociobiologist, Edward Wilson, and he has described that the diversity is there at all the levels of organization. So there are the three level of diversity they have shown here. It is again an important question. So genetic diversity, that means in a single species what is genetic variation is there, the different types of genes, or you can say the genetic variation present in a single species is actually termed as genetic diversity. So here it is been defined: a single species might show high diversity at genetic level over its distributional range, means wherever it is present, in that it shows the various genetic variations, so that it is considered as genetic diversity. Here they have given the example of Rauphelia vomitaria. This is the plant which is a medicinal plant growing in the different ranges of Himalayas, and in term the potency and concentration of active chemical reserpine the plant produces. It has various diversity in terms of the chemical it produces and the potency of and the concentration of that chemical. So India has more than 50,000 genetically different strains of the rice plant. This is another example. 1,000 varieties of mangoes. This is another example. That means in one species only as many varieties are there. So this is called as genetic diversity. Then it comes the species diversity. Species diversity means, suppose they have here taken up the example that in Western Ghats have a greater amphibian species diversity than the Eastern Ghats. So diversity at the species level, if the various types of species are there in the given area, then it forms the species diversity. It comes the ecological diversity. Ecological diversity means various types of ecosystem. At the ecosystem level, what all diversity is there? Like desert ecosystem, rainforest ecosystem, mangroves, coral reef, wetland estuaries, alpine meadows, has the greater ecosystem diversities. In these climatic condition, the various types of ecosystems are there, so that it is forming the ecosystem diversity. Then the Scandinavian country like Norway. That means in our country, as many number of different types of ecosystems are there, but in the Norway, this is no different types of ecological diversity is seem to be found. So it has taken millions of years for evolution. We know that during the course of evolution, the various characters keep accumulating, and then it develops evolve into a new species, and that way our Earth planet has become very rich in diversity. So it took millions of years. We have already completed the chapter evolution. In that, this concept is very much clear, that how do the new species arise from pre-existing species. So this, it takes millions of years for the formation of new species. But we could lose all the wealth in less than two. They are saying that if we will not conserve our diversity, if we will not take the right step, and if we will exploit our environment as we are exploiting it, then very soon, just in 200 years or in two century, we will lose the wealth of our diversity. Biodiversity and its conservation is now a vital environmental issue of international concern. As more people around the world begin to realize the critical importance of biodiversity for our survival and for our well-being on this planet. So in this chapter, we will be discussing how we can conserve our biodiversity, what is the need of conserving the biodiversity, what are the causes of loss of biodiversity, what are the patterns of distribution of biodiversity. These all topics we are to discuss next. Thank you.